Let's start with the basics today. Let's make perfect rotis. Hi, I'm Aprongirl and we are going to learn how to make those perfect rotis two ways. Our video is a step-by-step video and I'm going to teach you how to knead the dough, how to roll out the roti and how to roast them perfectly on flame and on the tawa. So that if you have an induction and not a cooktop, you can still do it. But first, please subscribe to our channel and like us across all social media. So first things first, here I have taken about a cup of atta. This is whole wheat atta and we'll make about 5 odd rotis. So here's my atta. I'm using a big thali for this or a big plate. You can also use a mixing bowl. And I put my atta here. Here we go. I'm going to make a small well and I'm going to gradually add room temperature water. Please remember, gradually add your water. Do not put all the water at once. Here, slightly start mixing the atta or your whole wheat flour with the water. Few drops or maybe, you know, a few tablespoons at one go. Here I go again. Little bit of water. Can you see the amount that I'm putting? It's not too much. It's very, very little. And I'll just keep moving my hands so that I can mix this dry flour with my wet flour. Just keep mixing the atta. I have taken about a cup of water, but I'm adding it gradually. Your atta might need a little more or a little less. It depends on flour to flour. So do not, there is no proper measurement that I can give you, but just put little by little and just see it get combined gradually. You will have to feel it first. So here, this is the technique that I'm using. Just make a fist out of that atta. The one that you have added water in, and it'll start coming together. So just like in a fist, can you see this? Like in a fist. Yeah, I'm adding a few drops more, just a little bit, not too much. Please remember, do not add a lot. Here I'm taking up the little dry flour that is left and I'm using this bowl, the ball of kneaded atta here. With the help of that, I will just, you know, kind of scrape all the dry flour out of my thali. I'm using a thali. You could very well use a mixing bowl. You don't have to use a similar kind of utensil, just whatever you're comfortable with. Try putting or bringing this all together and it'll just take a few more minutes to come. Can you see this? This atta has come together. There are there is hardly any dry atta left. But this is not the stage that way we can make rotis. The atta is not ready yet. So you just cannot start making rotis here. We still have to knead this atta. We've just sort of mixed the atta with the water right now. It still requires a lot of kneading. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a few drops more water. Now we're going to use even lesser water than what we were using before. So just a few drops should do. Here we go. Just like that. Sprinkle those drops. And now it's a very simple technique. I'm still bringing the atta together. You can see now my hands are pretty clean. They were very messy in the beginning, but look at them now. They're very clean. Now the atta has come together and let's start with our technique. With the heel of my palm, I'm just going to push and fold. Push and fold. Push and fold. We will continue doing this for some time, for about 3 odd minutes. 2 to 3 minutes is enough. Push and fold. It's very simple. It's not a very difficult technique. You just keep doing this for some time. Push and fold. Push and fold. This is a real-time video. I'm trying. I will have to cut it in between just for so that I don't make it too long. But actually, all the steps are in real-time, so you can actually cook along with me. Just go ahead and keep doing the same technique, push and fold. If here we go again. Push and fold. It, just with the heel of your palm, push and fold. The art is getting a little dry, so I'm going to add a few more drops. Just few more drops. Do not add too much, or else your atta will become very, very difficult to work with. Here we go again. Push and fold. Push and fold. Push and fold. It's simple. It's not at all difficult. You'll find when you start working with it, you'll find that it is fairly, fairly easy. My suggestion to you is that you do this. You practice with it first, and then you'll see that it is very easy. I'm just pushing and folding it, pushing and folding it. Another pro tip that I would like to give you: start using smaller amount of atta first. So work with a small, work with a cup, and then, you know, work your way up to needing larger quantities. But first, start with a cup. Remember how all this was so messy right in the beginning? But now everything has come together. My hands are absolutely clean and the dough is pretty much kneaded. There is just one more step that we will do after we keep doing this. Now, there is step number two is I will take a little bit more water, just a few drops here, and I'm going to just put it on my dough. And with my fist, I'm going to make a fist with my hand, and then I am going to knead it with the fist all over. Knead it with the fist. It's almost like punching it, but like, you know, like they're like hard punches. And this we're gonna do about 3 or 4 times. This is not a very lengthy process, but what it will do is it will really develop the gluten in the dough. Which will make our rotis pretty soft, and you will realize that by doing this, these very small steps, it will make all the difference to your rotis. Now I will continue doing this for some time. I'll show it to you again. Make a fist and, you know, knock that dough out. If you're very angry, you can just do it on the dough. It's fairly simple. Now I'm not speeding up this entire process here. I am going to cut the video, but it is almost real time. You can, so that you really know all the steps. My dough is pretty soft. You can see that it is pretty soft. Now what it needs is a little bit more water, just a little bit more water to make it even softer. I'm just like wet my hand, and I'm going to put it all across the dough here. And again, with my fist, I'm going to punch the guy out. Here we go. Yeah, I just do this all over the dough. We're just almost there, guys. I mean, hang in there. It's easy, it's simple. And there will be a dream rotis coming up very soon. So here we go, just a little bit more needed. And now there is another very important step coming up here. I'm shaping this up in a ball here. Now what we need to do is, the most important thing that we need to do to this dough is, now we are going to rest this dough for about 10 to 7 minutes. The resting is very important. Once you rest the dough, it really is easier to roll it out and make rotis with it. It gets really easy to work with. And you can actually just use any other utensil and put it on it. But what I'm going to show you is a fairly simple technique. Pick this dough up like this. You can see it's smooth, it's got no cracks, it's pretty decent right now. We just need to rest it just a little bit. Look at that, it is absolutely smooth. Now what I'm going to do is, I just remove this here on the side. This is a muslin cloth that I have taken. You can take a cotton cloth also. I am just going to sprinkle some water. Actually, just sprinkle some water. It doesn't need to be too wet, it just needs to be damp. The cloth needs to be damp, not wet. So I'm just sprinkling a little bit of water here and there, and I'm going to cover my dough with this. So you see it's just damp, it's not wet, you can see that. Just cover your dough and keep it aside for about 7 odd to 10 minutes, and you can also keep it longer, but minimum is 7 minutes. I'll see you post 7 minutes. So my dough has been resting for about 15 minutes, but before that, let's talk about some basic things. This is a rolling board or a chakla. I'm using a marble one. You could use a wooden one too. This is my rolling pin. I've got a thinner version. You could have a slightly broader version, but technically it would yield you the same results. I have some dry flour here for my rotis. We'll shape our dough into balls and then dust them in this flour, and then we will roll out our rotis. So that's about it. But before that, what I'm going to do is I am going to put this tawa on the flame. I'm going to light my gas here and put it on medium flame so that my tawa gets hot enough, not too hot, just hot enough for and ready for my rotis to go up there. So here I'll put my tawa on medium flame. So let's look at our dough now. Look at that dough. It is perfect right now. It is soft and it is perfectly smooth. You can see this. Look at that. Yeah, it's just like that. It's very smooth. It's very pliable. Rotis will be really easy to make. Now, just let's start making these rotis. Now, you could also at this point put this in the fridge and use it later. But I'm going to start making my rotis now. So I'm going to take a ball here, almost like a table tennis ball or slightly bigger than that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it on my palm and I'm going to try and in the middle of my palm, and I'm going to try and make a flattened disc out of it. Now you would see a lot of people making these roti balls with in a million other ways. Some would, you know, just roll them and, you know, kind of make it like this. But what I'm going to do and what is best for a beginner is that you make it into a slightly flattened ball. Just ensure that it is a round disc, so that would help our rotis to, you know, kind of be round when we actually roll them out. So here it is. I am going to dust this in some flour, in some my dry flour here. And meanwhile, I will also check with my tawa. My tawa is nice and hot at this moment. Now I will start rolling this out. It's well dusted, you can see. And I will start, I'll put it in the middle of the my rolling board and I will start rolling. So gently, even pressure, not too much, not too little. It has to be an even pressure. And you can just keep moving the roti with your hand. Now ideally what happens when you're really practiced and you're really good at it, your roti moves and, you know, it revolves around the chakla just on its own. But if you're a beginner, it might not happen to you. So what you would have to do is you would have to take it with your hand and then keep moving it with your hand like this. So you just keep moving it with your hand. Do not put too much of the dry flour out there. It will make things messy and will also make your rotis really hard and very chewy. So don't put too much of the dry flour. Just keep rolling them. Try and roll this out as round as you can. Don't get disheartened if it doesn't look as round as my roti. You will get there with practice. My roti is almost rolled out now. I'm just going to shape this better. Here we go. And it is now time to put it on the tawa. Now we need one more thing to aid us in this roti making process. I'm quickly going to go and grab my chimta or a tong. I'll keep it here so that it is handy for me. Now the quick technique here is I'm going to pick up this roti with my right hand, put it on my left hand. Just like that, I'm going to open up left hand like this and then put it back on my right hand, because my right hand is my dominant hand. I'm going to gently put it on the tawa, just like that, without being afraid. It's fairly simple. My flame is still on medium and now I'm just going to put it back on slow again and let the roti cook for a few seconds before it is time to flip. Now with my chimta or my tong here, I will flip the roti. And here is my first flip is there. You can see it's not too cooked on one side. This is my first flip and it's important that it is only cooked this much. Now here again, here is my, now it's getting cooked from the other side. Now this side takes a little longer than the first time. So we are going to wait patiently. And here we go. Just keep checking it, not too much, but just check how far along your roti is. Now, it is important for us to see these bubbles on the roti. It's a good sign that my roti is almost ready to put on the flame. So what I'm going to do here now is, I'm going to check it once more, just like that. Yeah, I'm going to hold my chimta because I'm going to go right on the fire from the middle of it. It's easiest to do that. And now my roti is ready to go on the flame, and here it goes on the flame. And look at that, it is absolutely like a balloon. It's fluffed up, it's perfect, it's beautiful. Just roast it from all the sides. Do not burn it, just roast it. You could have a slightly more roasted roti, and my roti is ready. Now I'm going to apply my most favorite ingredient in the world, a nice dollop of ghee. Look at this. This is absolutely perfect. It's gorgeous. So let's try out one more roti. And this time what we're going to do is we're going to roll it out in the same way, but we're going to roast it differently. Now if you have an induction and not a cooktop or a gas like mine, you can use this method. Now we'll follow the same process all over again of rolling out the roti. Here is my flattened disc which goes in the dry flour here like this, and here I will just start rolling this nice and gently. Gentle movements, keep moving your roti so that just keep an eye on that flame of your tawa. Here we go, just keep rolling the roti nice and steady with a lot of confidence. Don't worry about it, it's going to come to you. Keep moving the roti on the chakla or your rolling board and rolling it out into as round as you can get it. Don't get pressurized into making it too round, or you know, it's okay. So here we go, it's almost there. Keep a watch for the sides. The sides should not be too thick, so just evenly, you know, roll out the sides too. Simple actually. It takes practice, but it's fairly simple if you look at it. Few more motions from my rolling pin and my roti is ready to be put on the tawa. Now here we go, put it on my left hand, back onto my right or my dominant hand, and gently I will just, with confidence, I will put it on the tawa. Just like simple, it's not just like that. So here we go, I'm going to turn up the flame so that I can, you know, my roti can cook faster. And my first flip is going to get ready very soon. Here we go, it's ready because my roti has started moving on the tawa. It's a good sign for your first flip. So here we go, we will flip the roti the first time. You see, it's not too cooked from one side. It only takes a few seconds for the first flip to happen. The second flip also takes a little bit, naturally takes a little bit longer to get cooked. So for example, here just keep having a check on it. Keep an eye on your roti, it should not get burned. If your tawa is too hot, your roti will get burned very fast and will not, you know, fluff up the way you want to. Now the roti here, I've taken a muslin cloth here to aid me into roasting this roti. Now I flipped it again, and with a muslin cloth I will start pressing the sides of the roti so that it fluffs up from the middle. And you can see how beautifully this roti has fluffed up on the tawa. So if you're using an induction, this is a really important way for you. You can still make rotis on an induction, you just have to follow this method. It's a little different, your roti will look slightly different from the one that is roasted directly on the flame, but nevertheless, it's still a soft and nice roti. My roti is almost done. I'm going to just roast it a little more because I don't want any ends to be raw or very gooey. So here it is, my roti is done. It's looking slightly different, but tastes very nice nevertheless. Just look at that. It's fluffed up, it's nice, it's soft. What it needs is ghee again. Put a nice round dollop of ghee on it and it's ready to be served. Perfect roti for you, for those people who have inductions with them. So now there is no excuse for not making those perfect rotis. Go ahead and follow my video and make those perfect rotis. If you have any comments or any questions, do write to me in the comment section. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on our Facebook page. Till the next time, bye bye.